Chapter 1, Overview. Diesel engines are an integral part of the overall transportation system in the United States. These engines power every heavy-duty truck, ranging from semis, which travel the interstates, to delivery trucks that bring mail orders to your door. Diesel-powered engines are more efficient because diesel fuel is more energy-dense than its gasoline counterpart, meaning diesel engines burn a richer fuel and deliver a better fuel economy. They also have higher compression ratios, which help the engine extract more power from the fuel. This higher compression ratio increases performance and improves efficiency. Diesel engines are reliable and durable. It's not unusual for a heavy-duty diesel to get over 1 million miles in its lifetime. The average semi-truck travels about 100,000 miles per year. In the past 30 years, semi-truck fuel economy has improved 50%, and the life to overhaul has increased. A few short years ago, oil change interval recommendations were once at 20,000 miles. Current recommendations are for the 40,000 miles plus range. Diesel engines are modern and complex. They meet very stringent emissions regulations from the Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, and California Air Resources Board, also known as CARB. Diesel engines have sophisticated electronic control systems to manage their operation. All the modern diesel engines today have quite a few things in common. They are four-cycle, have compression ignitions, and are direct injection, turbocharged, and after-cooled. Unlike gasoline engines, diesel engines run with a significant excess of airflow. They are equipped with sophisticated after-treatment systems to treat exhaust before it's released into the atmosphere. In the 1990s, the Clean Air Act enforced regulations on diesel pollutants like nitrogen oxides, also known as NOx. Nitrogen oxide contributes to air pollution by combining with hydrocarbons in the presence of sunlight to form ground-level ozone, which leads to smog. Smog is a contributor to respiratory problems throughout communities. By 2002, the requirements for controlling NOx forced a major modification to diesel engines, adding EGRs, or exhaust gas recirculation. Introducing EGRs occurred because of the required reduction rate of NOx emissions to be over 50%. Timing and combustion modifications alone couldn't accomplish this reduction. EPA and CARB have also been tightening the requirements related to particulate matter, or smoke. In the past, managing combustion and air-to-fuel ratios fulfilled the smoke requirements. But in 2007, stringent requirements made the treatment of the exhaust after it leaves the engine mandatory. Although these after-treatment requirements resulted in a major change in vehicle purchase price and vehicle maintenance, the result was a much cleaner and eco-friendly solution for the country.